This is The Ambassadors by Hans Holbein the Younger. It's one of the most well-known double portraits ever painted, but it's also one of the most baffling, because hidden at the base of the canvas is a secret. So who are these men? Why are they surrounded by seemingly random objects? And what is that mysterious blot? We're exploring the answers to these questions and more in this video. Let's dive in. In much of Holbein's work, the devil is very much in the details, and this painting is no exception. When you look closely, it becomes clear that this is anything but an ordinary double portrait. For one thing, it's huge. At 81.5 by 81.5 inches, this painting is literally larger than life. For another, there's a gigantic, distorted skull hovering at the base of the painting, but we'll get into that later. For now, here's what you need to know to fully understand this painting. First off, who are these people, and why does this double portrait exist? The figure on the left is Jean de Danteville, French ambassador to England during the rule of Henry VIII. We notice two things about him immediately. One, he's dressed well in expensive materials, lynx fur, velvet, and delicate silks. Two, he is massive, taking up a full third of the painting. This is a man, Holbein seems to say, who has done very well. He's successful, a man at the apex of his career. He also commissioned this painting. The man on the right is Georges de Selve, French diplomat, bishop of Lavaur, and Danteville's friend. Although de Selve is less physically imposing, he is nevertheless a powerful presence. His robes are understated but expensive. As bishop, he was committed to protecting the Catholic cause against Protestant reform, which is significant because at the time of this painting, both men were in England, likely trying to stem the tide of Reformation. Here's a bit of background. In 1533, England was a hotbed of religious tension. King Henry VIII wanted to divorce his wife, Catherine of Aragon. He didn't have the Pope's approval, so he ultimately, controversially, would break with the Catholic Church, divorce her, and remarry Anne Boleyn. Essentially, it was a time of mounting instability which concerned then-King of France, Francis I, and Holbein manages to capture all of this in the painting. The floor is Cosmodi, the replica of the floor found in a sanctuary in Westminster Abbey, a bastion at the time of English Catholicism. Holbein roots the ambassadors in Catholicism, their stance, and by extension France's, on the coming religious conflict is clear. This conflict is further alluded to by the half-hidden crucifix in the top left corner of the painting. Christ's body is literally split in half, much like his church. But Holbein doesn't stop at circumstantial description. Like any good portraitist, he tells us something about his sitters. Jean de Danteville holds a golden dagger inscribed with his age, 29. He is young, wealthy, and action-oriented. Meanwhile, his friend de Selve's age is written on a book under his arm. He is 25, and possibly of a more passive disposition. Both men are, relatively speaking, quite young, yet they hold the high office of ambassador, and it would seem between them have achieved mastery of learning both earthly and celestial. On the top shelf, we see instruments used to measure the heavens. This collection includes a sundial and a globe depicting the positions of the heavenly bodies. Given Holbein's attention to detail as seen in his treatment of materials, patterning, and the Anatolian carpet on which these objects rest, for example, it's surprising that these instruments aren't strictly speaking accurate. They don't quite match up with each other, and there's a sense that this heavenly disorganization reflects the earthly disorder and religious upheavals of the time, on earth as it is in heaven. As expected, things don't get much better on the bottom shelf. Here, we find a lute with a broken string, indicating disharmony. A Lutheran hymn book open to Veni Sancti Spiritus, which translates as Come Holy Spirit, possibly an invocation to God to restore harmony in his church. A book on arithmetic, and a globe showing places relevant to Danteville, including Policy, the location of his chateau, where he likely would have hung this painting. The message of all of these objects is clear. The ambassadors are masters of heavenly and earthly learning. Here's the thing though, under all of these symbols of mastery in the arts and sciences, and in the midst of all of this religious and political tension, we get one thing. A blot at the base of the painting, which on further inspection reveals itself to be a massive anamorphic skull. It's kind of, well, gruesome, and it can only be seen properly from a certain angle. This painting was probably meant to hang in a doorway or a stairwell, and designed so that the skull would unfold itself as people passed by. It's a testament to Holbein's technical virtuosity as an artist, yes, but that's not really the point. Holbein seems to say that death underscores everything. Like the skull at the base of the painting, death is always present, yet we only see it at certain times and from certain angles. The skull is a vanitas image, a memento mori, and what it's saying in a sort of gallows humor send-up of the ambassador's joint achievements is that you might, like these two, master the arts, measure the heavens, practice diplomacy, level up socially, make a load of money, and otherwise achieve the markers of earthly success, but despite it all, you will die. All of these achievements will come to nothing. It's a grim prognosis, but it also leaves room for a sort of freedom. All earthly efforts will be swallowed up in death, yes, but this also takes some of the pressure and importance off of any achievement and puts things more or less in perspective. And this doesn't just apply to their collective achievements. Holbein is also acutely aware of the time-boundedness of his own artistic skill, of the fact that while his work may live on, he won't. In some sense, The Ambassadors is a dialogue, a negotiation, a diplomatic treatise, if you will, between the heavenly and the earthly, between life and death, between the temporal and the eternal. It's about the transitory nature of all things. So in the end, Holbein seems to say, remember death and live well. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, please consider supporting us on Patreon at the link in the description box below. Thank you all very, very much for your support.